The Greater Poland Province, the rivers they represent. Exploration revealed relics of Greek equipment from almost 2 years ago. Underground embankment, stone construction of a cargo center on one layer about 25 centimeters thick was registered. 1.5 meters westward of the standard object size 106 per 380 centimeters was excavated, which in the course of exploration was interpreted as burial. Further works led the archaeologists signs of intentional dismantling that conducts stone construction. They probably original framework and a cover of it. Now human remains were registered inside. They might have been removed for some reason. Apart from things out of that human interference, but the relics exhumation can be confirmed also by the fact of living in the grave pit. Some elements of this. Some elements of this mortal equipment. Empty pit 2 meters deep containment a glass pit. A quite spinning wall, iron nails, bronze and iron chest fittings, and fragment of a pontine and a bronze vessel. The finds included also soil cloths, which might have included textile relics. Separating the textile relics from the cloths was a great challenge, and although tablet twisted mass of fibres was visible, it was difficult to read the textile tag. Therefore, the work consists of precise removal of soil raising in. If our delicacy and cleaning it excess was unneeded. The treatment delivered several fragments belonging to different textile kinds. One of them is presumably a part of a bonnet made in sprang technique, webbed with thread. Sprang is a textile production made by interlinking, interlacing, and interlinking, twining of what was plated in various compositions, making seconds of a pattern created of loops. One fragment edge had a twisted string of a
Którym też chcę?
Musimy cofnąć, czy musimy?
Tak, cofnąć.
To tym?
Jeszcze?
Tak? Dziękuję.
One fragment edge had a twisted string of three threads, Z-span, plate S and plate Z. The second fragment fragment is woven open double. During analysis, we tried to find another thread signs which would indicate presence of another fiber introduced. For example, flex but no evidence was reported. Further, it should be stated that textile was intentionally manufactured in tabi of gauze like epidermis. The density for 1 centimeter was 11 threads in Z piece per 13 threads in Z piece. Analyses of particular thread fibers used in sprang indicate that in majority they belong to flaky fibers and possess layers of small scales on their surface. Thor, 197 exempt fibers, only 6 of them had clear core shape. Core shaping, but not fully developed. Average fibers thickness was from 8 to 18 micron. High wool quality depends on not only sheep species, but first of all on fleece processing. We are not able to estimate now is if fleece was cut once or twice a year. Wool combing, on the other hand, must have been perfect, probably by the means of hard combs. Next work was spinning with wooden spindle weft clay or stone spindle worms. In case of Grudna, we can speak about clay wool as such an example was found in the grave equipment. Had it been a grave of a woman busy with spinning? Life of a skeleton makes the answer to question impossible. If it had been a woman, she must have belonged to a tribal elite, as the grave also contained a bronze stand with a stamp of Publius Polybius. Who had been a Roman coppersmith manufacturing various vessels near Capua about 1st century AD. At this research stage, it is difficult to estimate if female graves had often been equipped with bronze pots, but it gives evidence in of intense trade and cultural exchange function. In northern sea route and included southern zone of Baltic coast. Such exchange also influenced the novelities in textile production. Over 20 years ago, Yezhmai presented a hypothesis, a wool quality from Roman period obtained as a result of crossbreeding between sheep imported from the entire territory and local animals. As a result of the treatment, the sheep lobes were distinguished thin fleece and thick fleece ones. Thick fleece sheep were of Mediterranean origin, while the thin fleece ones come from the Middle East. First they came to Greece, next to Italy, where they got various names, Taranto, Greek, or Attica sheep. Breeders tried to combine cross breeds with local animals to obtain the highest fleece quality. Walton and Mike's study results indicate that local cross breed with Roman sheep are of a good quality. Following those statements, it can assume that wool used in Grudna products was of a local production, or came from Northern Europe and belonged to type 2, for example, of sowship, of woolly sowship. Of course, every following textile fragment excavated during archaeological exploration can confirm or negate the hypothesis. The problem requires many comparative tests, but first and foremost new finds from Northern Europe. The site in nearby Landerjelk, what's its name? The site in nearby Landerjelk delivered textile fragment in comparative studies will give an answer to the question if it is we say wool quality. History of textile products made in sprang technique is over 3,000 years old. They are now, for example, some Bronze Age of coffin burials in Denmark. Objects is that period included in majority relics of head covers. Textile products made in this textile technique were also perfect for making layered cloth elements because net made the way created the decorative and elastic details of everyday dress. Bonnets were the most readable in archaeological materials due to their rather small sizes. In Polish territory, we report the oldest textile fragment manufactured in technique this type, above in the burial ground of Lusatian culture in Świbie, Niewice commune, dated from early Iron Age, 65 to 40 century BC. Iconographical materials analysis shows that the net torches, a metal ring which served as a belt clasp. Similar net from was excavation in the tomb of Alicante, Spain, and it is the date from 4th century BC. Net fragments in sprang technique were also excavated in Lubowitz near Lendor, Wielbork culture, which came from grave equipment at times from the times close to Grudna textile defines. Similar objects are also reported in Northern Africa made of flax threads. For example, a net bonnet from the collection of the Museum of History of Art in Brussels. Next four examples of bonnets are in the museum collection of Georges Lamy, two of which were made of colored thread. Fragments from Grudna are made to, are made the same way as bonnet pieces from Ardennes, which is dated from early Iron Age. The brief review concerning textile manufacture in sprang technique indicates its popularity over Europe and North Africa in different epochs. Variety of loop composition crafting ornaments required great manual skills and special imagination in 3D in crafting patterns. Because even the is this composition would be an attractive ornamental form in itself. The material described above provokes many questions, which we are not able to answer at this research stage. We do not know the sex of an individual variant in the grave. Secondly, is the spindle wall and the sprang textile fragments sufficient material evidence to state that it had been a semi-burial? Of course, no. The technique was used for male, plus element manufacturing as well. And the spindle wall is not enough proof. Another problem the head cover is it a helmet or a carbon car. We do not know either if Polish territories report textile products in these techniques made of large steps. Textile discoveries from Grudna are unique finds at the moment. Malgorzata needed to machine or to necklace weight on this.